Pinterest is an amazing place for you to get traffic to your website. Well, creating Pinterest pin isn't that easy. There are so many tools that can help you create pins and you can post them directly to your website. If you wanted to create a pin, you could do it manually yourself, fill in the title, the description and every information and upload images. Or you could use tools that will help automate this process and make it very easy for you. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use a tool called Pin Generator to help generate Pinterest pins for your website without going through the stress of manually uploading everything yourself. So if you're new to this channel, my name is Michael and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this channel, I do create content on how to create content, digital marketing, and how to make money online. So if you do like content like this, do make sure to subscribe to this channel, have that post notification bell turned on, and do not forget to smash on that like button. And without further ado, let's get started. So the first thing to do is first create an account. During the registration process, you'll be able to connect your Pinterest account to Pin Generator so that every time you create a pin, it can directly be posted to your Pinterest boards or your Pinterest account. So to start using Pin Generator, all you need to do is come to the home page, and in this section here is asking you to choose a style. So you can select any of this style and click on this and enter the URL to your website and hit on generate pin. So what this is going to do is going to take you directly to this section where it's going to help you find all the sitemaps on your website or different types of content that you've published. And here you're going to see the detected sitemap. Click on this if you want the sitemaps for a particular category, just like post sitemaps, page site landing. So depending on the sitemaps you have on your website, this is going to be different from what you're going to see. You're going to see different posts within each categories that you can make modification to. So above here, you do have the numbers of pins you wanted to generate. You can increase the number to as many as you want to generate pins for, and then once you hit generate pin, it's going to find search within that category or find just all the contents within that category to help you generate pins for them. Sorry about that. I had experienced some technical issues, so I had to reload the page. So you can increase the number of the pins you wanted to generate to as much as you want. And once you're done, you can click on generate pins. Now what this is going to do is going to help you generate pins that are available within that sitemap. So once you have all the pins in your sitemap generated, then you can go further to make edits and make changes here and there. Another thing you can do is you can also select a board. So during your registration, you're going to go through the process of linking your Pinterest account to Pin Generator, and you'll be able to find all your boards in this category. You can also get a particular content to generate pins for that. You can go to a post, your post, and then copy the URL and come to this section here and paste URL. And then once you do that, you can come here and hit on generate pin for a particular article you have written. So you have several themes and several templates which is going to generate pin for just that article, and you can further make changes with the template if you do have a particular design you follow, or if you're consistent with a particular design on your Pinterest board or color. So you can come to this section here where it says color and fonts. Click on color and fonts and you'll be able to change different colors. If you selected this color, it's going to make changes just to a few of them. So if you'd like it to apply to all of the content, you can just click on tick on use all colors, and then you'll be able to see that the color has been applied to all of the content which is in this section here. You can change the font color to any color you desire. You can change it to blue, or you can use the default font color. You can make several changes to this to make it, to beautify it for you. In this section here where it says font type, you'll be able to change the font to any font you like, and it's going to apply across all. And you can increase the font size here And you can also decrease the font size. The font weight, you can change it to a higher weight to make it more thick. And you can also go back to the previous font weight you had. In this section here, URL length, URL weight, which is the URL that's your this URL, which is in this section, you can make changes to the weight and color also in this category. So in the pin template section, you'll be able to find different templates. So if you do not like it to randomize it for you, just like it did here, you can come here and select a template that you want it to follow. So you can click on randomize and you can select different ones, and it's going to apply the changes in this section. But if you are interested in maybe just only one pin, you can just simply click on which of the templates you want, and it's going to apply to all of the pins which is to generate for you. If you scroll down further, you'll be able to see the image section. In the image section here, you can randomize an image to use different image here for your content to mix it up for you, and you can also make the image contained to make them full scale on your pin. You can also untick it to make it just the way it was. You can upload a logo if you want a logo to be added to your content. I do have one here. I'm going to upload this logo, and once you do that, you're going to see the logo across all the URL section of your pin. And then you can also upload an image if you do not like the image which is has been used for a particular content, because these images are from the sitemap of the URL you have provided. So you can just drag an image and drop, and then the changes will be made and applied in this section. So the next thing you can also do is select URL to generate. Now that is if you wanted to generate for multiple URL while still maintaining this. So you can add URL in this section or search for URL that you can use. Okay, so the bulk action section here, you'll be able to do things like schedule your pins and more. But you can also schedule a pin by hitting on this to help you schedule a pin. And below here, you have the video section. So this is integrated with Pixels, but this works only if you want to generate a pin video for your Pinterest board. And this section here, you do have the Etsy store, so you can integrate it with your Etsy account and post directly to your Etsy store. So what this does is simply pulls out information from your website or the URL you have provided, and then use those information to help you generate a pin. And this is how it works. So you can come here and click on Edit Pin, and then you'll be able to see it has pulled out the title of the contents which I had written, the website. In this section, you can change the website which is going to be on the pinned URL. This is the description to the content. It's going to pull that up, so you can also make changes, and any change you make here only applies to this one. So if you want to change the board, you can also select, sorry, if you want to change the template, you can also come here and select different templates that you can use. You can go for text side only, but I do prefer the standard. In this section here, you can change the image which is on the particular pin which you have created. I can click on this, and this is going to make these changes by applying just this image. And once you're done, you can hit on save, and to pin it directly to your pin board after making all the edits, you can come to Pinterest and then click pin to Pinterest. And if you'd like to schedule, you can come here and hit on schedule. And if you'd want to download a particular image, you can click on download pin. Another way you can share pins to Pinterest is by using the bulk action, and this is very easy. All you just have to do is come to the section where it says bulk action, set the title for your pin, description, an outbound link, which is the link is going to be taking people to the link to your website or your post. So, and then set your URL for all pins. And once you do that, you'll be able to publish directly to a particular board. Now, after making changes and posting from pin generator, the pin will automatically be posted on your Pinterest board or dashboard. And just before I conclude this video, one more thing you need to know is that it has a free account and a paid plan. So in the free account, you do have 15 pin credits per month, which you can use to create pins on your pin board. And with the starter account, you do have a $9.99 monthly payment, and you'll be able to get 100 pin. The business account, 600 pin credits per month for $16, and then the enterprise with a 1,000 pin credits per month for $29.99. So if you're looking for a pin generating tool that can help you automate generating Pinterest pin so that you can spend more time on growing your business and less time creating pin, then I do recommend you use Pin Generator. You can give it a free trial and see if it's the tool you would want to use. So thank you guys for watching this video, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you did find this video helpful, do make sure to subscribe to this channel, have that post notification bell turned on, and do not forget to smash on that like button. And I hope to see you guys in my next video.